Greetings, retro gamers. I'm Richard Evans, aka Retro Rich, Richard31337 on Twitter. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you about my jailbroken Neo Geo X. I've had Neo Geo X about a year. I'm very happy with it. A few months after I got it, I investigated or heard about the possibility of jailbreaking it so I could play a lot more games. So initially, I think 36 games came out on the Neo Geo X. And with the jailbreak, you're able to play most of the 148 games available for Neo Geo. There's a few that won't play. I do know, for instance, that Viewpoint doesn't work. It's not available. But, you know, there's most of the others are. Oh, and Aero Fighters 2 also won't play. But there's most of the games are available. It does, you know, I think. What we are going to cover in this video are the technical aspects of the jailbreak, like the fact that each of the games has got the Universe BIOS installed. We're going to play some of the games which have been suggested by friends on Twitter and YouTube and on the Atari Age Neo Geo forum. And I just wanted to talk about what a great intro I think the Neo Geo X with the jailbreak is. It's a cool system as it is, but you know, it can also emulate other systems too, so it turns into an emulation platform, which is another reason why it's great. It's got a good arcade stick, which is obviously based upon the same mouldings as the Neo Geo AES, and plus also it is a portable console, so I'm sure you've already heard about the Neo Geo X, so I can take it out of the dock that came with it and I can take that with me and play Neo Geo games on the move. What is not covered in this video is I'm not going to be reviewing the Neo Geo X itself, the hardware or its software. That's been done to death. I mean, there's lots of hate for the system, unfortunately, due to many things. I think the initial firmware that came out had some serious graphics and sound flaws. They did fix some of these later on. It is improved. Definitely HDMI output is much better than using the composite video, I've found. But the sound is pretty good most games. There are some emulation issues on some games. It's not perfect, but I still think it's a great system, and with the jailbreak it makes it really cool, because you know, it's helped me decide which games I want to buy for my Neo Geo MVS, which I've covered in other videos. Well, there's quite a few games that have been suggested by friends. A lot of them were official releases for the Neo Geo X, but because of the fact I want to make this video interactive and I had thrown it out there to ask people what games they wanted covered, I've gone with them anyway. There are a few games that aren't available without the jailbreak, and you'll see some of those. I'll also show you some of the other systems that are emulated with the it also does Capcom CPS games. There are also many 8-bit, 16-bit and earlier consoles emulated with many games, and you can just download the ROMs if you obviously own the game, and play them on your on the Neo Geo X with a jailbreak. So I've done that. I've got quite a lot of games on here, obviously games that I own, otherwise that I'm emulating. So without further ado, let's have a look at some of the games. So, well, first of all, this is what you'd normally see with a Neo Geo X. You see the games that are installed with it, and if you install one of the cards, then you'd be able to play the extra ones. I've got the Ultra Pack, Mega Pack, sorry, which has got all 15 of the extra games they released it later on, and these are the games that came with it. But here we have a Neo Geo game card, and if we go in here, there are many different sections. So we've got Neo Geo, Capcom, that's the CPS, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Sega Genesis, Nintendo Entertainment System. We have got PlayStation now. I haven't got any games on there because they do not emulate. It's not good. I think, you know, it's really pushing the system at that point. Who knows? I know that there are other systems that are available to do these, and if you want to do PlayStation games or anything newer, then maybe that's the way to go. I've ignored those. Sega Master System is fine. Super Nintendo is fine. It does the Atari VCS, but let's have a look at the Neo Geo section. So if we're in here, one of the things you get with the jailbreak is that all of these graphics are included. So, you know, omg-snk has spent a lot of time making sure that these graphics are there for you, so you can have a, you know, They look nice. Otherwise, they just come up with a generic Neo Geo icon. So we go back in here. You can see all the games that are available. I mean, there's literally pretty much all of the games. So if you hold down Start, you can go through letters. So that's what we look through. Z, then go through the numbers. Alpha Mission there. B, that's what we'll go through from B. Cyberlet, Double Dragon, Ape Man, Fatal Fury, all of the Fatal Furies there. Ghost Pilots, Casino Encounter, all the King of Fighters series. We're going to play a couple of those later. Last Blade, Last Resort. As you can see, all of the ones you'd want to be seeing on here. So I'm going to do them in the order that people suggested. I've got a friend in the organisation that we have online called Gaming Illuminati. His name's Peter, he's from Netherlands, and he suggested Magician Lord and Nightmare in the Dark. So Magician Lord does come with Neo Geo X, so we'll have a quick go on that, and you can see what that plays like. And then Nightmare in the Dark is one that was not officially released with the Neo Geo X and is part of the Jailbreak. So we'll select this, and we'll go straight into the Universe BIOS, because I want to put it onto the AES home console version. Here we go, so you hold down three buttons there. Select USA, I think, and, oh no, I've, yeah, and console there. So you can go through. I don't know if you're familiar with the Universe BIOS, but this is available for, you know, you can play all the sounds from the cartridge. It's quite good if you want to record the audio. Gives you some other settings. You can select whether you want Japanese, USA, or Europe. I'm going to put USA there, and whether you want the arcade or the console version. And some games differ quite a lot. I think Top Hunter has was covered by Jared from Project COE. He mentioned this to me, and I didn't realise, but the home console and the arcade version of these games differ a lot. There's extra levels, I think, on the home console version. But anyway, we'll go for console there. Press C to get out. We can also, at this point, if we want, let's hold down Start. We're going to reboot the system. I'm going to hold down B, C, and D, and we're going to go into the actual MVS BIOS. So you can actually do that as well. So it is like an MVS. It shows you the slot one, Magician Lord's in there. So we'll look through the settings on here. Infinite continues, difficulty level, all these things. So you can change all of this. You can, I mean, obviously the timer is not set. It's not going to remember. It's got no battery to remember the time. But as you can see, it looks just like the MVS system. Right. So here's Magician Lord. Now I have this on MVS, but I haven't played it for ages. So let's give this a go, shall we? I mean, it's a pretty beautiful game. I think it's one of the earliest releases on the Neo Geo. Might have been a launch title, actually. It is a very difficult game. It's quite unforgiving. If you get hit, you don't have much. I mean, I think you can stand like two hits, potentially. It's very difficult. And you pick up this, and then I'm going to turn into this guy with the flames, and in a minute these horrible things are going to start flying into the side of the screen, and they always get you. So about now, normally, is when they come, these little flying things. Here they come, and they're very difficult to dodge. Oh, I managed it. Really difficult game. Ah, see, now I've gone back to being the magician again, the Magician Lord. I'm not going to be playing much of these games. I'm not going to spend a long time. I'll feature them in the video, but this isn't about playthroughs or reviews of these games. It's just really just to show you what the Neo Geo X can do and can't do. I think you just saw a bit of screen tearing there. You do get that. Actually, there's screen tearing on some NPS games. I mean, it does happen. You get slowdown as well, which you get on some Neo Geo games. It's never going to be as good as the real hardware. It's an emulation at the end of the day, and maybe not that powerful. Oh look, I'm going to die now. Must get out of the flames. Oh god, here they come again. They always see, if you hang around, they get you. See if I can get to the boss, maybe. Oh god, here we go. These things are evil. Ah, that's it. That's me gone. Anyway, if you want to, you press select, you can then go back to the main menu, or you can play the game again, or you can press... Oh, actually, do you know what we must do? I just want to hear some of the terrible translation in this. Oh no, it's when I kill the boss, isn't it? It's what imprudence. Anyway, go back to the beginning again. We'll pick Nightmare in the Dark, which is also suggested by Peter. So, here we go. Yeah, Mr. D, they are Nightmare in the Dark. So we'll put it back to the home console version again when the Universe BIOS comes up. Just do that quickly. We're not going to go into the NVS BIOS. The reason why I'm putting it on console mode is because it means I can press start to play the game. If you put it on NVS mode, you have to put a credit in. And one of the downsides with the Jailbreak, and I suppose maybe, you know, that could be remapped in a later Jailbreak, is that you have to press one of the shoulder buttons on the Neo Geo X in order to insert credits, which is annoying, because if you want to play it from your stick only, we're not going to load this data. Oh, that's actually, I'll tell you about that in a minute. Actually, no, we're not going to load it, but basically it loads. We'll just reset that there. We'll reboot the system. If you want to just use the stick, you have to get up to go and put credits in. I think they should have used maybe the select button. If you tapped it, that would put credits in, but I don't know. I didn't obviously write the Jailbreak. Nightmare in the Dark is actually a game I'm trying to get for the MVS. I so far haven't managed to get hold of a copy, but I am looking out for it. So, I'm going to be the Gravekeeper. Right, let's have a go at this. Quite like this game. Right, so yes, every game, it thinks you've got a memory card in, so you can actually save your progress, and that is saved when you switch the system off. So, that can be quite nice if you want to play through, like things like Baseball Stars. Needs a card, really. It doesn't store your high scores. I think most people know that, but it stores game progress. Anyway, let's have a go. Nightmare in the Dark. Played this for a long time. Oh, I'm trying to. What do I have to do? Oh, that's it. You have to do it. Here we go. That's it. I remember now. Oh, level those. Oh, goodness me. Missed them all. Very bassy music. Obviously, we're listening to this through my sound system, and it does make a massive difference. You get full stereo sound out of the HDMI, so you get to listen to the sounds and all the games in all their glory, even if you're dying. Ah, got to put them on fire. There you are, and I can throw this ball at them then. Like I said, I've not played this for ages, and I'm not particularly good at it anyway. I'm not going to get that in time. What does that give me? Range up. Oh, that's quite good. dear. As you can see, I'm going to have to play this more. Obviously not very good at it. Right, well, there, I'm out. Obviously didn't do very well. It's not even going to ask me to put my name in because it's so terrible. What a terrible score. Anyway, let's hold down that. And we'll move on to another game. So we've got a guy on Twitter, Adam Chater, suggested three games. First of which is Samurai Showdown 2. So let's have a look at Samurai Showdown 2. So we hold on, like I said, start, and you can skip through the games in order. Samurai Showdown 2, here we go. What we might do is have a quick look in the MVS settings for this one, because even though I'm putting it into AES mode, you still get the MVS and you can turn on blood and things. I'm not sure whether this will have that. So we're going to go console, exit out of that, and hold down. I have to reset it again. Yeah, here we go. So Samurai Showdown 2, blood display on. Yeah, okay, so we're all good. So we'll skip that. Okay, future is now, SNK. I own this on the MVS. Haven't played it for a while. It's a lovely looking game. Good sounds. Anyway, let's have a go at this. What we've got option. Put it on MVS mode. Oh, okay. Don't know about that. Exit. Right, let's go. Who should we have? I'm not sure. Can't remember who I'm good with. Well, I don't think I'm good with anyone actually, but let's have him. I must apologise, by the way, that my television is not very elegant when in 4x3 mode. Oh god, I hate this guy. Yeah, so you get these horrible grey lines. Oh dear. I'm shockingly bad at this. Oh, did a special move. Oh dear, things all over now. Oh, yeah. Not my victory. Cham Cham's victory. I don't know what he's doing there. I'm not very good at this game. I've got some kind of pot thing going on. Anyway. Oh, come on, Rich. I've got to be out. Oh. Some of that. Come on. Ah. probably best not discuss this anymore. As you can see, Samurai Showdown 2 plays quite well. So, thanks, Adam. get to see how terrible I am at these games. Let's play Metal Slug. That's another one that Adam's suggested. By the way, but all of these games are available with the Neo Geo X without the need for the Jailbreak. But one other thing, here we go. Let's go into here. I don't think this has got the blood on as default in the no, it hasn't on the non-Jailbreak version. So here we go, American version. And then we'll go into the settings. Blood is set to off. So we'll turn that back on. Difficulty 3. Surely not. Here we go. Let's play some Metal Slug. I own this on MVS as well. Very enjoyable. Metal Slug. Let's look at what we've got in here. MVS Hero 3, yeah, that'll do. So, no, we're not going to load anything. It's Marco, let's go. Now this one does suffer from screen tearing, but it's perfectly playable. Oh, I've missed them. Have the fish. Ah, shocking. Come on, Marco, you can do it. I want that. Should we get in there? We'll get in there after we've done this. But you forgot I had those. Die. Oh, I did it. Would you believe? Okay, what else did Adam suggest? He suggested King of Fighters 98. Now, I don't think 98 was available. I'm not sure. On Neo Geo X, can't remember, I'll probably be wrong about that, but certainly King of Fighters 95 is, which is another one we're going to have a go at. King of Fighters, oh, hold on, what's going on there? King of Fighters 98, that's the one that Adam wanted. I truly suck at these ones though. There we go. I'll just boot it in, just check there's nothing in there. Is there anything about blood or anything like that? Blood's on, yeah, good. I don't own this one on NDS. Let's look at the intro a bit. Doing single play, I think. Yeah, so what the options are in there. Okay, difficulty MVS, exit, single play. Who should we be? Oh, let me guess. Where am I? Oh, right, okay. Like extra advanced, I don't know what this means. Fine, I'm going to be very predictable and play with Terry. So at least I know some of his moves. Yeah, that works. And that works. Oh. Yeah, cool. Makes sense. Checking. Ouch. Wasn't very friendly. Have some of that. Go, Terry. Well, I don't know how I did that one. Not very good at this. Oh dear. Have to destroy him. Die. Go on, have some of that. Yes. Yes, Terry, you are a winner. Anyway. That's enough of that one. What's next? Crisis Core 1980 rather. He said Windjammers, which is a great game. It is available on Neo Geo X in official release. And I own it on MVS as well. Really enjoy this one. I think also Alex Oz Retro Gamer suggested this one, but it was already taken. So he's got another game coming up in a bit. Okay. Versus computer. And there's only one that I can beat. Miller. Because he says things like, good show. All right, we're on the beach. Tell you what, that freaks you out on the MVS. But anyway, right, as we go. Can I do any semblance of good with this? Ah, no. No, obviously not. Gonna get completely ruined. Oh, what was that? Come on. Ah, time up. I must beat him. Oh, what was that? Yes. Got a comeback. Good show. It's a decider. I have to finish this game. Oh no. Maybe we should stop now. Oh no. I'm going to blame the joystick. I'm much better on the MVS. Ah, no, it's all over now. 9, 8, 7. There's no way I'm going to get... Oh, that was my chance as well. Lose. Moving on. Oh yeah, it's saying, do you want to save? Definitely not. Right, who's next? Lewis White with King of Fighters 95. There's a lot of games, so it takes a long time. I should probably have done this in alphabetical order to save time, but anyway. There we go. King of Fighters 95. This one was released with Neo Geo X. The Jailbreak is incredibly easy to do. You literally just need the rocket cable, which comes with any of the other game packs, or I think omg-snk can supply one. Should we search to see if there's any settings in here that we want to look at? Blood on. Oh, blood colour on. Okay. Yeah, so you just literally boot it up as if you're doing a firmware update and it installs the Jailbreak. Yeah, I've got this one on MVS. Got quite a cool intro. So let's play MVS single play. No. And guess who I'm going to be? Yeah, you've guessed it. There he is. Ah! Oh, it's not going to work on this one. Terry against Terry. He's got wise to my moves. Ah, he's going to kill me. Well, at least Terry wins. That's all I'll say. Ah! Some of that, shall we? Ha! Huh. Oh, come on, Terry. Shocking. You've improved, all right. But I still want easy. We do next? Right, we have, no, we're not saving that, another suggestion, this time from Ant Harper, the Retro Games Collector. So he wants Garou Mark of the Wolves, which was as part of the it does come as part of one of the packs, but it's also one of my favorite games, fighting games, and I spent quite a lot of time playing this one with my son when I first got this, and I have now recently got it on MVS. Again, it was quite difficult to get hold of that one, well, for a decent price anyway. It's quite expensive generally. Can't remember if there are any settings worthwhile looking in here. Probably not. Okay. Some great tracks on these systems. Right, let's have a look here. What are we doing? Survival mode? I don't know. Story mode. Loading. No. And there he is. Let's put him in his red get-up. Right, and this is it. I think we'll go for there. Get serious. Ah, it's gonna kill me. No. Jumping over those, stop it! stop jumping. Ah! Oh my goodness. Right. We could try it. Ah! No, that's it. Over. I'm thinking seriously about not uploading this to YouTube. It's showing how terrible I am at these games. okay. Oh well, you get it, warts and all. Right, next game we have is suggested by my friend Brad from the Gaming Illuminati as well. And he suggested that we play Ludo and Monopoly. So if you just hold on a minute, I'm going to go and get the games. Obviously, I'm not going to go and get those games, but he did, when I pushed him to suggest a Neo Geo game, he did suggest Neo Turf Masters, which I actually quite like, and I own on MVS as well. So thanks for that, Brad. I think you were actually the first person that replied. With your board gaming suggestions. Quite a nice nice game, this one. I'm not really into sports sims, to be honest with you, but I did buy this one because I really enjoyed it, playing it on here. I spent an evening playing it. I was like, I've got to get this on MVS. Hold on a minute. Yeah, that's not the game that we wanted at all. There's my little joke, obviously. I think I was looking for Turf Masters, not Neo Turf Masters. I don't know about that other game. I've not played that one. Oh, hold on a minute. What is going on here? It is there. It is Turf Masters. We'll get there in the end, I promise. I've not played the other one. I don't know if that's any good. I might ask Brad because I think he likes his golf sims. Yeah, this is more like it. It's got some great arcade-y type music in this game. A great intro. Right, gotta pick that. I think I can remember this one. No, I'm not loading that. Please select the type of your game. Who do you play as? Well, I think actually he's probably one of the best ones, isn't he? We'll give him. This looks like quite good overall. Playing Australia. Good luck. It's really good music. Alright, we chose a wind. No wind, okay, so we're gonna go that way. Some of that. Right, we want to go for there and there. Roughly, not too bad. It's fairly easy to play this. It's quite nice to play with a mate. Wind straight on. So we don't want to go full power. Probably about there. Nope, not quite hard enough. Player one, third shot. That was shocking. Oh, I've not played this one for a while. Watch me slice it right over. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, maybe it's not that easy. It's been a while since I played this, right? Let's have a go. I'm gonna get this one. Still too hard, but I'm on the green. That always makes me laugh. Triple bogey. Oh! You must give up. Yeah, that's generally what happens when I play actual golf. I don't want to play any more of this. Oh dear, I'm terrible. Right, we've got another one here. Now, I have not played this for a long time, so I am definitely going to be rubbish at it. But Anthony from the Atari Age Neo Geo forum suggested Twinkle Star Sprites, which is conveniently right next door. So I think this game is some kind of witch on a broom thing, and it's quite cute, very Japanese. Wow, that sounds different. But it's a little bit like Puzzle Bobble as well, because I think you drop things onto the other player. Yeah, right, let's have a go. I don't know what's in here. Yeah, I do. Right, come on. Right, move the joystick, move the player. A is shot. B is bomb. Hold down A and release. Oh, I think that's pretty clear. Well, I ran. I even bought Drappy. Get a clue. Oh, that's brilliant. I think Andrew from the back office played this recently. Which actually sparked my interest into playing it again. And I think that's probably why Anthony suggested it as well. Oh, can't I get the B? I want the B. What can I do here? Can I? Oh, I can do that. Let's have a bomb, shall we? See what happens there. Looks like quite a cute game. Out. Oh, I've lost all my power up. Oh, that's good. I won. I'm not entirely sure how. I think I blew up something and knocked it over the other side to the other player, but. That plays all right. Sounds good. I mean, that's one of the things, is that all of these games, when you put them through the stereo here, they really do sound good, even though they're emulated and all that stuff. Wow, he's just going to drop something horrible on me there, I think. Anyway, that's enough of that game. play some more of that, I think, and get used to it. Right, who's next? Colonel Fancy, Blazing Star. Well, we can't... I've played this one quite a bit, some of you might know. But I did have a quick go on it earlier on here and I was terrible. So this could probably be the end of my Blazing Star career, this video right here. Let's have a look. Should we see, make sure the settings are correct as per the Twin Galaxy settings? Continue without. I might need that though. What else we got here? Level indicator with. We're on level 4. Let's do that, shall we? We can push through, press through these now. And here's the beautiful intro that I've normally got switched off, unfortunately, because the track sounds get a little bit tiring if they're on all the time. So generally, my MVS has them off, but I really do love the intro of this game, and the music's excellent. Blazing Star was the first game I got on my MVS. I think Blazing Star, King of Fighters 95 and Fatal Fury may have been the games I got with it, I think. But I spent a lot of time playing Blazing Star to start with, but I didn't realise quite how good a game it was. It's only more recently that I've got into it. Right. Okay, so I'm gonna pick the ship that I generally play with. No, I'm gonna not gonna load anything. MVS. Of course, the MVS, because we're playing the home version, it's not showing you the level, but you have just seen that I've just selected the I need leaf switches. How am I gonna do the fast firing? What am I gonna do? I better die really easily. Oh, almost died then. That could be a little bit embarrassing. Let's see if I can do the same as I normally do when I play it. Not liking this joystick as much as my arcade machine, I have to be honest with you. Aha! Oh no! Oh, it's all over now. How embarrassing. Oh, it's not too bad. I've lost a life. How bad is that? But 400,000. I had a quick practice earlier and I got 500,000, which I very rarely get on the MVS, so I don't know. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to cope with trying to finish the end this boss. This stick is not great fun compared to the arcade. I'm really used to that stick. Let's have a look, shall we? Maybe we can try. I'm also not used to this button. I really like my leaf switches, and this is not one. Maybe I could switch this out for a leaf switch. I don't know. Just can't fire fast enough. With a leaf switch, you can get it right on the edge. If you've never played with one, it really is the only way. I didn't point push that enough, but mm. I think losing your life's the most embarrassing part of that level. Right, well, we're not going to play anymore. I think... But as you can see, it emulates quite well. It's not bad. Not bad at all. I mean, I played this a lot, and it's not perfect here, but it's certainly passable and enjoyable to play. So, you know, I've played this a lot on my MVS, and I'm quite happy playing this on here. I think if I had the stick on my lap, it might help. I've tried to put it so that it's in shot so you can see what I'm doing, but it's not really necessary, I suppose, for this video. Anyway, that's enough of that. Only got a couple more to go. What have we got next? Okay, so Alex at Oz Retro Gamer, he suggested Shock Troopers, which he and I both love. That's... Oh, that's a bit slow, this. That is a downside. There's a lot of games. It's obviously not made for switching through the games like this. Shock Troopers. Right. It's also got Shock Troopers Second Squad there. I own both of these on MVS. And I've played the first one quite a bit, but not recently. I'll just check to see if there's any settings in here that we want to look at. Violence on, that's what we want. Lots of violence. This is a good game. I'll tell you what, you wouldn't normally hear it in the cab, but there's a lot of low frequency bass right there. It sounds excellent through my system, it really does. So I've got a subwoofer there, it does sound, the sounds are there. My cab doesn't do it, but it really does sound good through here. Ah, died straight away, how embarrassing. Come on. I'm gonna die again. Oh dear. Oh, I can't have that. I have to have a bit more of that, I think. Ah, oh, that's why I forgot about that. Ah, oh, see, I haven't played it for ages. You can dodge the bullets, can't you? By rolling. Ah. Sort of three-way. Yeah. Heavy. As you can see, this one plays just fine. Oh my goodness, I am terrible at this now. Perhaps I should have practiced before this video, but I just didn't want to spend ages doing that. It's long enough video as it is, I think, you know, without having to have spent hours practicing. That'll do. So sorry, Alex, I've let you down. I think I'll have to do a proper video of that at some point, just that game. After I practiced. And finally, I've got a suggestion. That's a good intro as well. From Michael for Mutation Nation. So let's have a go at that one. And I really haven't played that for ages. I think that's the kind of Double Dragon type one, isn't it? Need to, oh, there it is. Oh. Mutation Nation. There we go. Oh, it's more Streets of Rage, isn't it? Yeah. This one is released, was released with the Neo Geo X, I think. How do you use the... It's a way to get it, isn't there? Ah, that's right, I remember now. You hold it down. I should have looked at the instructions of how to play, shouldn't I? Ah, there we go. Look, that one's even got a nice little graphic there. No, we're not going to save it. Right, well, those were all the Neo Geo games, but maybe I can give you a quick demo of some of the other system games. So we go back, going to Capcom. So we got all of these games here. That's quite good. Alien vs. Predator. A Street Fighter and stuff on here. It's quite good. Final Fight. Forgotten Worlds, that's not good, and the reason it's not is because it is true arcade ROMs, and obviously you can't twist the stick so you can't turn, so it doesn't work, which is a real shame that they didn't map that to other buttons, but unfortunately not. Ghouls and Ghosts, I could play that, that's shocking. Giga Wing, or Geiger Wing, however you want to say it. All these games here. Pang. Pro Gear, I love Pro Gear, that's a good game. The Punisher, Quiz and Dragons, Street Fighters, all of them. Look, all the Street Fighters. Puzzle Fighters, Strider, now that's good. UN Squadron, what's that one there? Varth, Willow, X-Men. Yeah, so what should we play? Should we play some Strider? Let's play some Strider. Now with this one, they did use the select button to put credits in, which is quite nice. I love this game on the Mega Drive. Whoa, it's pretty loud. Maybe we should just turn that down a little bit. Yeah, let's do that. So. Oh. Mm-hmm. Shocking. What a surprise. I'm no good at this game either. Been a long time. Let's quit out of that. What else can we do? We'll have a quick go at. I could do. Do Street Fighter, but I'm terrible at that. Should we Pro Gear? Yeah. It's gone. Oh no, there it is. Put some money in. Who should we have as our gunner? Let's have her. Yeah. Excellent shooter map, it really is. Bullet dodging. It's all about the bullet dodging. Oh, I want those. Ah, or not dodging. There's a lot of bullets. Lots of bullets. Look at that. Oh my goodness. That's not going to happen, is it? What you need to do is, it's one of those games where when it gets really tricky, you need to do a bomb because it gets rid of all the bullets on the screen. Quite handy. Oh, almost got here then. Oh, really deep base on that. As you can see, that plays all right. What else can we play? Right, let's get out of here. So we could do. I think I downloaded. I saw the Streets of Rage. Sonic. Prince Shinobi. Look at all this lot. Look. See all these games? Look, what's your list? Micro Machines, Michael Jackson, Boomwalker, Lemmings, Herzog. Here we go. This is a good game. I suggested this earlier on this evening to Retro Gamer Daz, actually. He said he was going to start his Mega Drive collection in anger this year, really increase it. And this is a game I suggested to him. Really good game. Player, user, computer, wide. Yeah. Okay, for that one. I'm not going to play this properly. Just wanted to show you that it plays. Oh yeah, that's got. Some screen tearing going on there. It's not perfect, but I do own this on Mega Drive. It's playable. That looks the same. It's when you're flying. Look at that. Like I said, it's not perfect, but you could play this on your handheld. You could play this. It would be possible to play. What else we got here? Should we just see what Sonic looks like? Should we give Sonic a go? What was that? Shadowrun. Look at that. Who's played that? Sonic the Hedgehog. got Sonic in the Mega Drive 2 there. Music sounds a bit off. Oh, it does sound a bit dodgy. How's it play? Oh, some tearing going on. I don't even think I'd never played Sonic before. I completed it at Christmas. Just for fun. When I got that Mega Drive there. It was a Christmas present, so I thought I'd have a go. It's playable. It's not perfect. It's doable. The music is not great. Anyway, you get the idea. Something that is quite good is because you could save all the games, you see. So I think I was playing on the Super Nintendo. I think I was playing, got Chaos Engine, look at that. Super R-Type, Super Mario World, Super Mario Kart, Super Mario All-Stars, Simpsons, R-Type 3, Qbert, Parodius. Oh yes, that's a good game. Micro Machines 2, Micro Machines, Legend of Zelda, Link to the Past. I was playing this. I was playing it handheld. It was really good. I own this on SNES. There we go. Yeah, the only problem is that when you play it handheld, you get the shoulder buttons, so you can press the L and R buttons, but on this, you can't, so you have to play it handheld this game. That's the only downside. But anyway, as you can see, what else have we got here? We've got Atari. Shall we play some of this? I can't remember how you play this. What are you supposed to do? You're supposed to... That's it. Anyway. There you go. So we've done some Atari as well. There we go. bit of Mario. I'm really not good at this game. There you go. So you can see that you can play NES games on here as well, which is kind of nice. I mean, it's got like an 8GB card in it, so you can imagine how many games are on there, or you can put on there. Should we have that as well? We could get that. Got to do that. Ha! Yeah. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you agree that, you know, you've enjoyed. Well, you can see that there's lots of options with this system. The Jailbreak really makes a massive difference. And please, you know, comment, send me messages, come and follow me on Twitter @Richard31337. Let me know what you think. Thanks very much.